My case is more than 100. 22-year-old female patient from Alexandria, student, single, non-smoker. She came to our clinic complaining from abdominal pain 3 months ago, fever 1 month ago, vomiting of blood 3 days ago, passage of plaque tire stools 3 days ago. The condition started since 3 months by abdominal pain, which was chronic in onset, progressive course, colicky in nature, mainly very umbilical, increased with eating with mild relief by analgesics associated with vomiting. 2 months later, she developed fever reaching 38.5, more at night, decreased to the baseline at morning, associated with significant weight loss without any night sweating. 3 weeks later, she suffered from hematemesis of moderate amount without blood clot and coffee grounding color associated with melema. She did virology screenings that revealed hepatitis C virus infection confirmed by PCR and ultrasound abdomen and pelvis that revealed focal hepatic lesion. As regards the past medical history free, post surgical history free, drug history free, family history irrelevant. By physical examination, the general examination, the patient was conscious, cooperative, and oriented to person, place, time. Head and neck was free, chest bilateral equal air entry, heart S1, S2 heard without additional murmur, abdomen, diffuse abdominal pain, mainly periumbilical with splenomegaly, 2 fingers below the costal margin, with hard inconsistency around lower pool, smooth surface, no shoes not felt, mobile with respiration. Upper and lower limb were free, vital signs, blood pressure is 110 over 70 millimeter mercury, pulse 80 beats per minute, respiratory rate 19 cycle per minute, temperature 38.5 degrees Celsius. As regards the lab investigation, starting with the CPC, hemoglobin is 8.9 gram per deciliter, MCV 71.4 FL, MCH is 22.4 BG, MCHC is 31.3 gram per deciliter, platelet is 108,000, white count 3,600. Liver and coagulation profile, ALT with 10 units per liter, ALT 20 units per liter, total bilirubin 0.5 mg per deciliter, alkali phosphatase 57 units per liter, albumin 2.8 gram per deciliter, hemoglobin activity is 114%, INR is 0.8. As regards the renal function, serum creatinine 0.5 mg per deciliter, blood urea is 13 mg per deciliter, electrolyte sodium is 139 millimole per liter, potassium 3.1 millimole per liter, calcium 7.5 mg per deciliter, phosphorus 3.8 gram per deciliter. As regards the inflammatory markers, the CRP is 138.6, ESR is 68. The LDH was 3, 4, 6 units per liter. As regards the infectious markers, hepatitis B surface antigen negative, hepatitis B core IgM and IgG negative, hepatitis C antibody was positive with PCR 6.69, HIV were negative. Upper GI endoscopy was done that revealed the gastritis. At that point, we did Helicobacter pylori screening at all negative. After a detailed history with the patient, it revealed she is taking non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs abuse. CBC, microcytic hypochromic anemia with anisoprachelocytosis, leukopenia with absolute lymphopenia and thrombocytopenia. Serum iron with 11 microgram per deciliter, which is low. TIBC with 349 microgram per deciliter. Blood culture, urine culture screening for fever, were no GRAS. Ultrasound, the gluteal region due to the history of multiple IR injection, revealed ill-defined echogenic and edematous fed glands with no definitive loculated collections. We did CT, chest, neck, abdomen, pelvis with triphasic liver that revealed multivasologically elongated deep cervical lymph nodes, bilaterally supraclavicular lymph nodes about 9 millimeters. Multiple mediastinal lymph nodes and bilateral hyperlymph nodes, multiple pathologically enlarged mesenteric lymph nodes, about 3.3 centimeters, hypodense hepatic lesions, splenomegaly 15 centimeters, mild ascites, features suggestive of lymphoproliferative disorders. So biopsy from the mesenteric lymph nodes was done CT guided because it's the largest lymph node. And we found this hypoalbuminemia in this case. The albumin may be low due to acute phase reactant, but also we have to exclude other causes. So protein creatinine ratio was done 1.7 gram. So nephrology consultation was done for renal biopsy and the result was membranous glomerulonephritis. At that time, the result of the biopsy revealed non-Hodgkin lymphoma and a bone marrow, short bone marrow invasion. 1 week later, she came to the clinic complaining of abdominal distension and tensor ascites, two scaleless ascites, triglyceride with 3 to 0, with triglyceride 1.1. So we finally can diagnose our case by non-Hodgkin lymphoma stage 4, hepatitis C virus and membranous glomerulonephritis. Hepatitis C virus inducing lymphoma and lymphoma inducing membranous glomerulonephritis. There is many architectures about the association of hepatitis C virus with non-Hodgkin lymphoma. The non-Hodgkin lymphoma is strongly associated with hepatitis C virus was proved in the last two decades. The most common type is B non-Hodgkin lymphoma. There's another article, and this is important. There is significant association between persistent hepatitis C and B-cell non-Hodgkin lymphoma. Diffuse large B-cell lymphoma is the most common type, and this tick, reshop, this R is anti-CD20. Our case was CD20 positive. Also, fortunately, the treatment of membranous glomerulonephritis is included in the treatment of lymphoma. It is taking a cycle of steroid with cyclophosphamide, which is included in the reshop therapy. Hepatitis C virus-associated lymphoma, according to the guidelines, should be treated with interferon-free, ribavirin-free regimen, according to above recommendations in combination with a specific chemotherapy, given account of possible drug-drug interaction. So this case will take the treatment of hepatitis C virus therapy together with the treatment of lymphoma and the treatment of lymphoma, including in the treatment of membranous glomerulonephritis. Thank you.